Hey there, I'm Shelly Brisbin, and I'm here to demo a new feature in iOS 16.4. Specifically, it's in the Weather app, and even more specifically than that, it is for people who use the VoiceOver screen reader that's part of iOS. VoiceOver is a tool used by blind and visually impaired folks to hear the contents of the screen rather than viewing them. So using a combination of speech and touch, you can find out what's under your fingers, and that's pretty easy if the content is text or even something that can be described pretty easily, like a button, something you can label. But if you have something like what you're looking at right now, which is an overlay from inside the Weather app, it's a little harder to use VoiceOver to describe it because it's visual and it's color-coded. We're looking at a weather overlay that shows precipitation. I'll just call it rain because every time I try to say precipitation, I say participation, and that's embarrassing. There are also weather overlays for AQI or air quality and temperature, but we're going to use precipitation. We're looking at East Texas right now, and there's some precipitation in the area, but there are also areas that are not having rain. So what we're going to show you is what I call sonic overlay. It's an overlay on top of the overlay that uses pitch to indicate the level of precipitation or the level of rain. See why I said I was going to say rain? I should have stuck to it. The level of rain that an area is having right now. Also, if you tap on one of those buttons, if you tap on a town name, you'll often get, and not always, but you'll often get the amount of precipitation that is expected in that town, what the chances are, I should say, which is different. So let's see how that
Wix,
works.
30% chance of rain.
So yeah, 30% chance of rain in Wix. Not happening right now, though. So what I'm going to do, when you interact with VoiceOver, if you tap on the screen, you're hearing what's under your finger. If you double tap, you're interacting, whether it be with a menu or with an app. And in this case, I'm going to do what's called a double tap and drag so that I can acquire information about what's under the screen, or under my finger, I should say. But also, I'm able to change the place I'm at on screen. Here we go. I'm going to double tap and hold. Notice the pitch increases. There's more rain. Go a little further west, there's more rain than there is further east. So it's kind of an interesting way to figure out the extremes of a storm system.
30% chance of rain.
So if I leave my finger on a town with this double tap and drag going on, it will read me the anticipated chance of rain. But if I just keep dragging and moving, it will continue to show the pitch, display the pitch. You'll still hear the tone. I'm not going to go away even if there's a very low chance of rain, but it's relative. So let's try another one. Kind of wobbles in and out a little bit. And you see it gets really low over here. Now, this is the first time I've seen anything like this in an app. The closest that we have to a VoiceOver feature like this is a feature called Pause to Follow in Maps, where if you drag along a road at just the right angle, you can get a vibration that helps you stay on the road versus going off the road. So it gives you an idea of the shape of the road. It also tells you what intersections you're coming close to. Not particularly useful for real-time navigation, but certainly a good way to understand your surroundings. So it's kind of fun to see this new weather feature taking its cues from this old maps feature of Pause to Follow and adding a cool new way for VoiceOver users to interact with overlays. Thanks for watching.